this installment of the upper series, we will be working on the hip relax, which creates movement. I will show first in place, and then we'll do the walking version of the same thing. First, we will start by simply relaxing one leg at a time, leg from the hip and down. So here, relax one, I relax the other. Obviously, if I do it one side at a time, I just bend from that leg. If there is support, I bend, I tilt, or whatever. Now, what happens if they do it in sync? So there is a relaxation here, but a movement in the other leg. We have coordination, or cooperation, if you like to call it this way. So we are relaxing and relaxing. Now the hips, the center of the hips does not move, but everything moves around that. You are creating movement in the lower back, in the sides, in the stomach, and obviously in the legs. If you do it further on, you can even lift the legs over, you can even hit the air. I'll show the same thing from the side. I'm relaxing from side to side. My center does not move. I'm just shifting like a boat in the water around it. Like so. Next is side to side. Again, the center does not move. I'm simply moving one hip forward, one hip back from the center. How am I doing it? Two muscles of the psoa work here, connected to the one muscle here that connects to the lumbar support, my spine and so on, and then it coordinates together, so forward and back, and here forward and back, without twisting as a foot. So relaxing one part and moving everything with relaxation. I'll show the same from the side, from here, relax it. Now we'll combine both of them together. What do you get when you get two vectors coming together? Either a triangle or something that's moving. So I'm moving in circles one after the other. It's this movement and this movement together. Circles one after the other. And again, make sure that you are aware of your leg. If you're just pushing them, you're just tilting and hinging on your joints, not using them properly. If you have one bone here, two bones here, there are two sides to the knee joint, so you have to be aware of both of them. This will really help you be able to walk at old age. So I'm going one direction circling, other direction circling, from the side, one direction circling, other direction circling. Why is this important? When something comes towards me, I'm just always just relaxing in several directions, forward, backwards, in each direction for one. I mean, I'm just able to not shrug it off, but just move with that instead of trying to control it, be against it, and so on. Now let's just tilt the center of the center here, to side and to side. Here the hips as a full are moving, both legs are cooperating from side to side. There is obviously a shift in the mass dispersion between the legs. Make sure that you're aware of it. If you're not, it won't work well. So side to side. I'll show this way. And then forward and back. So forward and back. Don't go overboard. Just relax forward, relax back, like so. I'll show from the side here. Forward and back. There isn't a tilting of the pelvis in this movement, not yet. So I've done this. Now I'm going to add the movements that we've done so far to this. So I'm starting with a boat tilt this way, and I'm going from side to side and reversing the direction. What happens is very simply an 8 pattern that simply correlates one over each other. I'll show from the side to from here. You can also do this on one leg. Very much appreciated by your body prior perception system. So, and also you learn to actually be alive in your feet. Now I'll move forward and backwards, and I'm moving forward and backwards as I'm doing the same both side to side, changing directions, again forward and backwards with the boat side to side, like so. Now, this movement. So the center stays, I'm moving hip forward, hip back, adding the side to side motion, forward and back, other direction, and then opposite, and from here, again, side to side, turning, hip forward, hip back as I'm moving, and forward and backwards, adding that tilting back and forth. You will not have back pain if you're aware of what you have, if you don't injure yourself, or someone else does it for you. After we've done this, that's the X, that's the cross pattern. Now we'll do the X pattern. So from this point, we are moving 45 degrees. So from here, I'm going sideways, like so, and adding the motion, adding the other motion, which means that I'm simply rocking the hips side to side, or rocking the hips back and forth. That's all. It's incredibly easy. All you have to do is just paint an 8 figure in each direction, just follow along. Or not paint and just be aware. Other X, I'm going side to side, front right 45 degrees, back other way, and now I'm 45 degreeing it, one direction, other direction, good to get tickets if you want to shimmy your way here and there. We've done the cross, we've done the X, we've done it in 3 dimensional. Now we'll actually move the pelvis itself. So from here I'm going tilting up, tilting back, like so. I show to the side, from here up. So if you're a man, you're just aiming for a different spot on the toilet, if you do that. Or if you're a woman, you're simply sitting down in a way. So from here, like so. And the other version of just side to side, we've already done. So now we're going to do a full circle with the pelvis circling itself. So from here, what's happening is this doesn't move. Everything moves around that. I'm controlling the 4 facets of the legs, front and back, side and side, to coordinate forward 45 degrees, 90 degrees. 45 degrees to the back, 45 degrees, 90 degrees to the side, 45 degrees to the front. And don't hurry up, because you just get all sorts of kinks. Just relax, breathe continuously, and let the movement come to you. Now let's get to the meat of it, actually walking this way. So, don't try to be a monkey, we already are. So I'm relaxing my hip forward, but I'm doing the circling motion. So from here I'm relaxing, I'm lifting and moving myself. What's wrong? I'm over-exaggerating. So as this is relaxing, this needs to relax as well. Over and forward, back and back. I'll show from the side, from here. I'm relaxing backwards, I'm relaxing one leg forward, the other leg relaxes, evens out back. It looks a bit like stumbling or falling, in the beginning especially. Make no sound as you walk, especially if you have shoes on, and then you just be able to relax the foot off the ground instead of lifting it off the ground like, you know, like a snow trooper. That's a lot of tension. Instead, relax it, then it comes and just touches the ground. Just like if you overextend this motion, it lifts the leg, it relaxes the heels off the ground, like so. This is the forward and backward movement. Just relaxing from one leg to one leg in three-dimensional rolling movement. Another way to do this is to just slowly relax both legs forward and not fall, and then you have one leg forward. Then you learn to brace. You learn to brace, you learn what excess tension is. So I fall, I brace fully, I relax. Right? Fully and relax. That's another way of learning to walk from this way. Remember, practice everything from the beginning. You don't have to go everything, but everything as you go with this helps you turn into different motion from you, different motion from you, and everything will connect into being seamless with yourself, not having bits and pieces coming together. Thank you.